Hello viewfinders, greetings from India. Thanks for the kind opportunity to present a paper in this prestigious Virtual Viewfind Summit 2020. And our deliberation deals with Viewfind and Koha integration covering all three generations of connectivity approaches. And the backdrop is that in India, we want to build a virtual union catalog of Indian universities by using Koha ILS at the back end and Viewfind in the front end as discovery interface. So let us start. As you can see, we are trying to build a union catalog. So the views related to union catalog is important. It's an age-old concept related with the library domain. So the classical view is that it's a list of the combined holdings of several libraries. The modern view says it's a single point access interface for the holdings of several libraries. But the futuristic view says that it's a single point access interface, of course, with DI, discovery interface, along with OPAC functionalities. So this is the futuristic view related to union catalog. If we look inside the higher education system of India, it is one of the biggest higher educational system in the world. We have around 1,000 universities, 40,000 colleges, 10,000 plus standalone institution, and many universities are located in rural areas, almost one third. But when you come to the library automation of these universities and other academic libraries, then like other part of the world, it is also heterogeneous in nature, and we have union catalogs, but only a few, and these few are far from the modern views of union catalog as we discussed. From this slide, you can have an idea about the Indian situation of related to use of ILSS. So there are three categories of ILSS presently we use: ILSS of foreign origin, both commercial product like Alice for Window, Virtue ILS, and open source product like Evergreen and Koha. Then the second category is the ILSS developed on the top of ILS of foreign origin, and third category is ILS of pure Indian origin. So it's a heterogeneous mixture of ILSS as far as Indian universities are concerned, but for the last 4 and 5 years, one particular trend is coming. So most of the Indian universities are using either Koha version 16.x to 20.x or Sol 2.x. These two are the mostly used ILSS in Indian higher educational institutes. Now, on this particular backdrop, the question is that is it possible to develop a framework for union catalog of academic libraries in India by using Koha at the back end and Viewfind in the front end? How and to what extent is it feasible to fuse OPAC functionalities like real-time item availability status, hold preference settings, different kind of ILSS based authentication in such a union catalog framework? So this particular deliberation is searching answer to these two questions. Now, before making a quantum jump inside the result, let us go for some kind of fact finding related to national level and global scale union catalogs. So most of the these union catalog supports only finding functions and neglecting the OPAC functionalities like real time item availability status, hold preference, ILS based authentication, extended search feature like features like full text search, faceted navigation, and most important nowadays, FRPRized display or grouping of resources. Now let us start from India. So the largest union catalog of India has been developed by Inflipnet. It is available from indcat.inflipnet.ac.in. Here you can see, this is one example I have given. Effective deduplication has been done. ILSS request form can be generated. Many search refinements are there, but it fails to produce any real-time item level status here. And this is the ILL request form, but as a whole, no real-time item level status, no OPAC functionalities, no faceted navigation, only search refinements are there, no FRBRized display, all edition of a work are not grouped in one place and no ILS based authentication. So here you can see the another example. This is the CSIR, Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, the largest chain of national laboratories in India. All of these 42 labs under CSIR use Koha as ILSS. By utilizing Koha OAI PMH compatibility, they developed a virtual union catalog where only title and author is visible along with the holding library, but no other information, and in no sense it matches with any kind of definitions of union catalog, so I am not commenting further on it. Now, if we make a query into the fact that what is happening in the other countries and at the international level, let us start with UK. So, COPAC recently changed its name to Library Hub Discover. This is the National Union Catalogue of UK. Here you can see effective deduplication has been done against a particular book. And it says clearly that in which libraries these are available. But if I click here, suppose in British Library, it will tell me the details of that particular book, including location of the copy, but no real-time item level status. So it says clearly here live circulation data is not available. Now if we make an inquiry about another greatest digital library of our time, Trove from Australia. So here you can see if I search by a particular book, it can go for effective deduplication. So this particular work is available under six libraries, and excellent or marvelous FRBRization of all four editions are grouped together, but no real time item level status. If I want to know what is the status, I need to go to the respective OPAC like National Library of Australia. Now, if we come to the global leader, that is WorldCat. So WorldCat initiated lot many FRBRization experiment like OCLC Fiction Finder, but they never implemented, not yet implemented FRBRization in WorldCat. You see the same book what I searched in Trove, I also searched in WorldCat. So all expression and manifestations are displayed separately. And if I want to know the real-time item level status of this particular document, so it says the effective deduplication has been done. So it says that there are this many five libraries, participating libraries are there where this particular book is available, but no real-time item level status, rather they are referring to the respective OPACs. So this is the situation with the global leader. So facts in a nutshell, we can say that no union catalogues is using ILS to design union catalog. Union catalogues are using discovery interface as a single point search entity according to the modern view of union catalog. Union catalogues are mostly gathering metadata through harvesting because most of the backend ILSs now are OAI-PMH compatible. Most of these services implemented deduplication, gathering all items of the same manifestation in one place. A few of these services like Trove have successfully implemented FRBRized display, that is gathering of all manifestation, all expression under a particular work. But almost all of these union cataloging services fail to implement minimum OPAC functionalities, as I said, like real-time item availability, holds preference setting, ILS-based authentication, and so on. So why this is happening? Because simply ILSs don't talk to discovery interface there. But holds on, there are some exceptions. So the first exception is the Ohio Link Classic. So it has got a 24 participating libraries under Ohio Link Union Catalog. This is their older version. So here I search by the same book what I searched in WorldCat and Trove. So here you can see no FRBRization, no deduplication. But if I click any of this particular book here, it can generate real-time item level status inside discovery interface. So what ILS they are using? They are using Opal ILS, and what connectivity protocol they are using? They are using ILSDI for the old catalog. But recently the system has changed. Now they are using the modern version of it. So here I search the same document. Now you see the effective deduplication is there. it identified two libraries on this particular item. If I click this particular item, it can tell me that these two documents are available in these two libraries and both are available. So real-time item level status it can generate. What they are using, they are depending on the RESTful API. They are using Sierra ILS at the back end and ENCODE discovery interface in the front end. So real-time item level status it can generate, but no other OPAC functionalities, no ILS based login, etc. So if we come to the finna.fi, here you can see the searching of a book shows that effective deduplication has been done. Partial FRBRI's display is also available, and real-time item level status can be generated brilliantly in this discovery interface. So here you can see right from here it can tell me that these two libraries are actually, these two items are not available from these two libraries. I can select any other library here. So from the drop down list, suppose I am selecting the last one, and it can tell me that this particular document or this particular item available from that library. And I can also log on to place a hold and to perform many other basic OPAC related functions. So real time item level status alongside ILS based authentication is possible here. Here you can see if I click the logon, I can use from the drop down list my library. I can utilize, I can give my login and password, I can enter, I can place a hold, and I can perform many other basic OPAC related functions. So basic OPAC functionalities are assured here. And yes, it's ViewFind, all you ViewFinders know very well. So as a whole, we can take a decision, or we can make a conclusion that most of the Union Catalog supports only two functions of a catalog, to find and to select, but not neglecting the third function that is to locate. And ViewFind may take care of all these OPAC functionalities as discovery interface of Union Catalog if configured in a multi-backend driver environment to handle multiple backend ILSs. And DI and ILS connectivity approaches in ViewFind have improved greatly in recent times. So what are these improvements? So as I said that these three generations of connectivity between the ViewFind and the ILS that is there. So generation one is based on the database call approach. Particularly, I am talking about in the context of Koha ViewFind connectivity. So generation one is based on the database call approach, which requires database level authentication. And right from the beginning, it is there. So generation two is based on the ILSDI protocol to connect Koha and ViewFind, but still we need database level authentication. And it also provides basic OPAC functionalities within the DS, like hold placement, profile update, etc. The first Koha ILS driver came inside ViewFind in release 3.1 in 2016. And the generation 3 is the REST-based connectivity, where you do not need database level authentication, but that kind of authentication can be done through OAuth2. It's a more secured protocol. And it also ensures a lot many enhanced OPAC functionalities within the DI, within the discovery interface, like holds placement, holds cancellation, profile update, article request, etc. So first REST based connectivity came in ViewFind through Voyager RESTful in 2014, then Sierra REST in 2017, and finally the latest one is the Koha REST, released in July 2020, so very recent. So let us go for our test plan. So test plan is that we are going for going to develop the Union Catalog based on Koha and ViewFind integration. So ILS we are using Koha 20.05.04, then DI we are using ViewFind 7.0.1, the latest level release. Environment is multi backend driver. Data gathering protocol is OIPMH. All backend ILSs are OIPMH, and we gather data through harvesting. Total 6 university libraries holding with 1000 data in MarkXML format from each library. And now the question is that what connectivity approaches will be suitable for DI to ILS linking. methodology we follow to prepare a single central index for all six libraries and test all three connectivity approaches in a multi backend driver environment. Now, before entering into the details of this test plan and the result, so let us take a look at what is ILS and DI. So in 2017 onwards, library community felt a need for a protocol to integrate discovery interface and ILS systems. You can see the statement given by Peter Branthle, a DLF, Digital Library Federation Executive Director. So Barclay Accord came in 2018. So you can see the list of the big names, both from the commercial domain and from the open source domain. So they came together to form a protocol to accord that all ILS should support harvesting, availability status, and linking with DI. So the result was the development of ILS DI standard. First version came in June 2008, and the latest one available December 2008, version 1.1, that is the latest and presently available. So what ILS DI is saying, ILS DI is gathered all to actually they advocated 25 functions for data aggregation, real time search, pattern functionalities, and opaque embedding. So these four group of activities includes 25 functions. Then with the emergence of REST based API, Koha community started exploring also, apart from ILS DI, different kind of REST endpoints from the version 17.11. And presently there are 56 plus endpoints as on September 25th. It is in version 1, still under development, but more and more REST points will emerge in future, and this ensures more and more opaque functionalities at the discovery interface end. So they created one test bed also where many new REST based API can related to Koha can be tested, can be checked, and can be discussed. But the question is that what are the differences between OIPMH, ILS DI, and REST? So let us take a look. So suppose I am asking an OI response from Koha. So in metadata format, OI DC. So here you can see this unqualified DC, there is no concept of item, only the manifestation level data is coming. But if we use the metadata format as Mark XML, it is much more comprehensive in compared with OIDC. Here you can have item related data in 9xx tag of Mark, but not real time availability of that particular item in a library. So here we can utilize ILS DI for some additional functionalities. What is this? So Koha integrated all these 25 functions into four groups. In some of the functions covered by OIPMH, some of the functions they have developed. So what is the relation of this particular functions with the accessing data from the backend Koha ILS? Here you can see in this particular example, if I make a query to Koha ILS DI PL that get availability item ID is equal to 1 and for all BPU ID is equal to 1 and item ID is equal to 2. That is for two items under the BYT is equal to 1. Here you can see here in this red circled line that item ID is 1, BYT is 1 here, then under that BYT item ID is 1, then this can tell you that whether it is available or not, and it can tell you in which from which library it is available. Similarly, here you can see BYT is still 1, but item ID is 2. Availability status is there and holding library is there. So additionally, we can produce item level status by using ILS DI call. Similarly, we can also get different kind of pattern information by utilizing this. Here you can see through this call, I can generate different pattern related information like username, their date of expiry, and many other things. So you can see this red block here. But what REST API can do additionally, in comparison with ILS DI, so more and more endpoints are now possible. It can return data in JSON format. It can be more dynamic. More conditions can be added. For example, in this particular API, REST API call, I searched all patterns with the city that is in the address field is equal to a given city, Kollani. So it can generate that these four users are available with the city is equal to Kollani, and in any one of these I can click and it can generate all the data in JSON format. So that really opened up many more avenues for DI to ILS connectivity, real time information availability from the ILS end. Now the methodology we followed here can be divided into three groups: ILS layer, middle layer, and the discovery layer. Here in the ILS layer, you can see that three tasks is there. We need to make Koha backend, Koha OIP image compatible, ISDLI compatible, and REST compatible. REST compatibility requires some additional work. In the middle layer for ILS DI and Koha database call, we need no additional tasks, but for Koha REST plugin, we need to install Koha plugin REST DI developed by Array, Mozilla, and others. We are using here version 0.8.6. And in the discovery layer, the most challenging task is to preserve BYD, unique BYD from each participating library. So indexing requires bit tinkering, and we need to develop a multi backend driver to cover or to include all Koha database call, Koha ILS DI call, and Koha REST call. So let us discuss these three issues separately. So issue one, or issue zero rather, creation of REST API user with prescribed minimum permission. So here you can see after your REST API compatibility is achieved in Koha, then you can create a user, you can give different kind of minimum permission. These are the permission set prescribed, and after that is over, you can go to the task 2. There you can generate client ID and client secret, and you can check by entering the user login and password that what kind of functions are available inside Koha. So it is providing you the minimum level authentication, circulation, and pattern management. Now issue one, that is the indexing. So suppose there are six instances of Koha here. Each of these instances will be having biblio number with ID 2. So when you index the first one, then you index the next one, and in index the third one. So every time this biblio ID will be replaced from instance 1 by instance 2, then from instance 1 by instance 3, and so on. So at the end of indexing, you will be having only biblio ID from the last instance, that is Koha instance 6. So to avoid that kind of situation, what we did, we developed a marked local Koha ILS properties for each participating libraries with prefix, say Koha ILS 1, that indicates coming from the library 1. Then import Koha ILS 1.properties to indicate that this particular marked local properties will be utilized. And during the indexing process, we utilize -p switch to indicate the import property, import.properties, which on the turn in contacting marked local properties and indexing accordingly. So in this way, you can preserve unique BYD for each participating library. So here you can see the result. So this biblio 2, now it is become biblio Koha ILS 1.2 from the library 1 and Koha ILS 2.2 from the library 2. And here it can generate real time item level status from library 1 and from library 2. So that is quite possible, although method is a bit tricky. Now the issue two, the multi backend driver. So what we are doing actually with this multi backend driver? So Koha on the one hand and Viewfind on the other hand. So there are six instances of Koha. There are all drivers are there, and we created three drivers for three generations of connectivity: Koha, Koha LSDI, Koha REST driver, and so on. Then we added a multi backend driver. There are three sets of multi backend drivers. Set 1 deals with the Koha, set 2 deals with Koha ILS, and set 3 deals with Koha REST. And you can see the result of this methodology. So this is related to Koha ILS DI. So DI is interacting multi backend driver as a proxy driver, multi backend driver by seeing the specific prefix of the record, it can contact the respective driver and it can contact the respective instance of Koha. So this is the first in case of ILS DI, this is the first instance of the driver. So here you can see we are utilizing different username, different database and different URL. And here point to be noted that we need to keep MySQL level or database level username, password and database. So this is for Koha LS2 and so on. So here when your multi backend driver is getting the prefix, it is connecting the respective Koha ILS driver and connecting it, and during the login also that is also done. So same thing is happening with Koha LS2 and onwards. Now this is the Koha REST, the same technology, but here you can see that we don't have to share the database username and password. So here we are giving only the client ID and client secret as generated in Koha. Then this is the Koha LS1, this is the Koha LS2, and here we are utilizing Koha REST which connecting respective drivers. So the result is that at the end of the day we can display lot many universities or participating universities, and user can select their university, can enter their login and password, and can enter inside the DI or discovery interface. So after entering in the discovery interface, this is the result. The first one is the Koha REST based login. Here you can see two are almost similar. Second one is the Koha ILS DI based login, but here additional functionality is the storage and retrieval request. But it won't be wise to think that the difference lies only in one particular OPAC functionality. The difference lies in the brilliance of the connectivity from the viewfind end to Koha end. So lot many more OPAC functionalities will be added here in future. So here you can see that after generation of the prototype with all 6000 data, we can now search, and in result it can tell me that it is this particular book. I search by web indexing, available from library 1, second one available from library 3, and the third one available from the library 2. In real time it can generate item availability status also. So result. Result is that security and confidence building in partner, the first requirement. In case of Koha database call and Koha ILS DI based approach, partners need to share Koha database admin credentials, a bit risky for partnership based initiative like Union Catalog. But in case of Koha REST, we do not have to share the database level password and login. We have only share our client ID and client secret, and that particular user is having minimum privileges, so it's not a security threat. It's a revolutionary improvement in security over the generation 1 and generation 2 approaches, and can build necessary confidence amongst partners. So if we come to the enhanced OPAC functionalities, most of these drivers support minimum OPAC functionalities in multi-backend driver, in the multi-backend environment. So Koha database call support all basic authentication, but cannot place or cancel holds in multi-backend driver mode, cannot change, modify user profile. So Koha ILS DI, apart from supporting all the basic functionalities, it can also support hold placement, hold recall, then profile update including password change option, but holds cancellation is not allowed and article request facility is not available. Koha REST supports all functions of Koha and Koha ILS DI apart from supporting holds cancellation, extensive profile data and storage and retrieval request, but it's a bit slower in transferring data sets from ILS in comparison with generation 1 and generation 2 driver. Password change option is not there like Koha ILS DI. So here you can see that Koha REST driver, what it can show after login. So here it effectively place the title level hold, it can support hold placement, it can support article storage request, it identified library but failed to identify the self, and in case of copy number it failed to give the copy number. Now if the same book with the login and password we check in Koha ILS DI driver, you see here the differences. Still we can place a hold item level and the title level, but copy number C1 and C1, it is there, copy number it can identify, but here you can see it missed the library. It can identify the stack location but or the item location in the library, but missed the library itself. But if we come for the same book on the top of Koha driver itself, here you can see it does not provide minimum OPAC level facilities like in a multi-backend driver environment like hold placement, etc. But it can identify the copies, It can identify the library and it can identify the location. Another, you know, CoHA-REST is the champion as far as OPAC functionalities and different kind of securities are concerned. But here you can see one point of caution is there. A search involving documents from all six libraries takes around 30 seconds to upload real-time item level status for set 1, that is 20 retrieve records in the first set, for a total of 12 sets, 236 retrieve records. But availability status in the detail page is instantaneous. So in compare with CoHA driver and CoHA ILS driver, CoHA REST driver is taking bit more time in displaying the item level status in the main search interface. So conclusion, it's there, it's too early to conclude because CoHA REST is only 3 months old, but the conceptual framework that supports REST based authentication between ViewFind and CoHA is simply brilliant. CoHA REST is more secured in compare with CoHA and CoHA ILS DI driver. CoHA REST does not require additional configuration in MySQL and MariaDB, and CoHA instances are in different machine. That is the case in case of most of the practical scenario, that will be the case. But in case of CoHA ILS DI and CoHA drivers need this additional work related to MySQL and MariaDB configuration. CoHA REST is most importantly independent of structural changes in CoHA side, whereas CoHA ILS DI and CoHA drivers need adjustment with the changes in CoHA side. I can give you one example, a problem we faced in ViewFind 4.1, where CoHA ILS DI driver required major changes when CoHA community decided to remove Mark XML out of the Biblio items table in CoHA 17.04, the PR I have given here. Now, REST endpoints in CoHA side will be growing with the time, unlike the fixed 25 parameters in ILS DI, and more OPAC functionalities will be added in CoHA REST driver in future. You have already noticed the article request option in CoHA REST, and at this point of time, CoHA REST driver is bit slower in comparison with CoHA ILS DI and CoHA driver, but I am sure that it will be solved in the forthcoming version of ViewFind 7.2. But deduplication and FRBRI's display are not there presently, so it should be the next target for such a framework. So thank you very much, stay safe, and a special thanks to Damien Kaj. And a special thanks to Damien Kaj and Array Mozilla. Thank you very much.